study completion. Then we are supposed to explore factors that inhibited or factors that facilitated at initiation after the study closure. I divide these two because as I'm going to be talking about the study design, it is a mixed method design, and I first carried out quantitative study first to first find out which clinics could have sustained the intervention, and then which clinics did not sustain the intervention, and then which clinics remained stable or decreased. And because of this, I randomly selected one clinic that was in the definition sustained, another clinic that did not sustain, to look at factors that have facilitated the sustainability in the clinic that did very well, and factors that inhibited sustainability in the clinic probably which performed poorly. We did a key for the quantitative was we collected chart reviews between 2015, that's August, up to 2016, July. And this data was compared with the data of STAT, which had been collected already in our database. Key format interviews, I targeted the clinic in charges, nurse ward counselors, any clinician and peer educators. You see, I combine nurse and ward counselors. Most of these clinics do not have specific counselors. You find that the nurses are those who are working as what? As counselors or even peer educators. So, as I said, there are 15 health centers. The start study was in 20, but I chose these public health centers because I knew that my study probably could be generalized in a public health setting. And they're all in Imbarara district, both rural and semi-urban. And patients, some of them run inpatient and outpatients, and they run Monday to Friday, some of them run once a week. Inclusion criteria was all patients who are attending each public health facilities initiated on ART, and they should have been initiated on ART during the study period, that's the study period, and also within 1 year after study completion. And exclusion, as long as you had prior ART treatment before the study, you're excluded. The samples, basically, we use patient charts. We specifically went, you got a database from the old health centers and was able to obtain the eligible patients. And then we did a systematic sampling of the charts, of which we did probably proportional size. Because these clinics are not the same, some clinics are quite health center fours, some of them are health center threes. Of which after the analysis, that's when I did the qualitative key format interviews. Four healthcare workers were picked from the clinics which did very well, and four healthcare workers were picked from clinics which did not do well to explore facilitators and barriers to ART initiation. So the ART reviews were originally collected data. This data had to be correlated with the start ART intervention. So we had to look at the data which correlated that ART intervention and to be able to tally the variables to be similar. And it was double entered and checked. Key format interviews, we had to test the semi-structured questionnaire, and then the interviews were conducted in English, and they were transcribed by two research assistants. In the analysis, objective one was categorical variables and continuous variables, the way categorical percentages, while continuous by mean and standard deviations, and we did a multivariate regression for those variables which were not balanced at the baseline. Key format interviews, we had to look for facilitators and barriers using the COMBI framework, which people have already talked about. What do we do? Because during the training of STATS, we had impact knowledge into health workers, so had to look at capability, and these people still have the knowledge which was being trained during the STATS ART intervention. They have the skills, then opportunity, they get the afforded time or facility where they stayed in that health facility. What about the influence? Probably could have been influenced by other people in the community, in the host health center. Motivation, could they have been motivated by other activities? Probably during our study, were they motivated to initiate patients? Did they feel they liked the study or not? So these are the things they went on to find out. Obtained ethical approval from all ethics review boards. And these are results. Sorry, the table is a bit crowded, but these are just baseline characteristics. And if you look at the baseline characteristics, they are all balanced apart from these four. Level health center, health center three, and health center four, there are differences. And probably my argument was, before when we started ART initiation, found that most of health center threes had just started to enroll patients, so they were new by that time during the start study. But by the time we finished the study, some of the health centers had already like they had already experienced now at initiation, so probably that could be the difference, could have caused the difference. And most of the people are located closer to health center 3s than health center 4s. Also eligibility criteria, so the asterisk means there are some missing variables. And eligibility criteria, you find that most, as we continue enrolling patients, the CD4 continued rising, and also the WHO, who defining stage, who defining illnesses of stage 4 and stage 3 decreased. So that could have also caused the differences. And also the TB, couldn't explain this very well, but I found that actually there are more TB patients initiated after the start intervention than before. This was the differences in the duration of heart initiation within 14 days, which is one of my primary objective of study. The main outcome, which was the primary objective, I found that there was a risk difference of 10.8%, which was significant between sustainability period and during heart intervention. There was a slight decline in the in my analysis of 77.4 from 79.6 from the previous results which were published. But this attributed it to one, I did this, it was a sample size, which called for me did the sampling, for the other the whole study took all the clinics. Then two, I left out the centers of excellency, just look at exactly how it is at the real public health facilities. So probably that could have caused slight decline by 2%. And in terms of sustainability period, it showed that it was an increase, but this was overall trend. However, there are factors which I could have contributed this show that there was a significant increase. One is during our study, we noticed that both the controls and intervention, there was a graphical increase in terms of duration of heart initiation. Sorry, graphic decline, reduction in duration of heart initiation within 14 days. So even the controls were increasing in numbers. So I believe that this increment continued even after the stats closure. Second one, I can't rule out that fact that most people are getting aware that there was a test and treat program which was coming up, having been already passed by WHO. However, my qualitative results could not, they really ruled out that people started test and treat during the sustainability period. Most of health workers who I interviewed, they all reported that they started test and treat in February 2017, which is basically almost 6 months at the closure of my study. Just this is a graphical presentation of how the time since at eligibility, in terms of people, how they are being initiated from day zero up to within 1 year, and the numbers which are being initiated. You can see, sorry, the graph is slightly tilted, but you can see that at the beginning here, there's quite a high number, which proportion coming to one. But as we continue, there are more patients who are being initiated with heart. But this is attributed because my sustainability was only 1 year, but my analysis of the start heart intervention was a full two and a half years. So in terms of facilitators start heart intervention, one, training and mentoring of health workers to acquire new skills. And also the second one was motivating them by provision of point of care CD4 count machines. However, the barriers were transfer of health center staff from one health center to another, which occurred in 2016. There was general transfer within Mbarara local government district. And actually some of the people were transferred. They were going to new environments. Some of them had not been trained prior to during the course of intervention. So this was really reported as a barrier. And also lack of continuous training and supervision. These findings, actually the first one and second one, they are not specific to also this study. I've done quite some reading about and found that actually the transfer of health workers demotivates them somehow, way much as others are motivated. And indeed it could also cause a barrier in terms of their work output. Also training and supervision, most of health workers were saying since the start intervention stopped, there was no one who could go back to train them, because during the intervention we're training them every 6 months. And also supervision, we're not going back, because by then we are sending their team almost every month. So probably this could also have caused what? A decline into our initiation. Then regular supply of usable cartridges for the point of care CD4 machines. During the start intervention, we used the PIM as an enabler to be able to provide RAS CD4 counts within 20 minutes. However, the start intervention provided the cartridges during the study. After there was an understanding with the Ministry of Health that they would be able to provide these cartridges. However, the health workers said that the supply was irregular, so they could not really enroll patients as it would, as it was in the STAS intervention. So what are my conclusions? The STAT intervention was sustained within 1 year after its completion, but there were different barriers and facilitators in different health centers, which led to health center variability and sustainability. This second conclusion, I didn't include the graph because we are given a limited number of slides, but there are health centers, each health center has had different percentages at which it performed after the STATS closure compared to how it was doing the STATS. So that's why I made that conclusion that there are different health center variabilities in terms of sustainability. My recommendations: implementation science projects should design a sustainability period in their implementation plan to assess uptake and reinforcement of activities after study closure. And also, Ministry of Health workers should be involved during implementation to train and mentor staff in proactive preparation for the final withdrawal of the study. Thank you very much. I acknowledge that the McKay University Implementation Science Program, which sponsored this study, and also my education, internal medicine, McKay University, and also my mentors, Professor Moses Kamia, and also Dr. Fred Semidara, start at partners because they collected the baseline data, and all other people who are involved in this study. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard. I think I will ask a question since you say you have not seen us. I want to give a chance for that. People getting very tired. Great analysis.
Okay. The risk difference, could you explain that?
There was a 10% increase in the heart initiation within 14 days. The 10% difference basically in terms of increment, heart initiation within 14 days of patients who are linked with ART after a sustainability study compared to the start ART study.
So the sustainability period was
increased.
Well, I'm asking so that people
appeared better.
Yes, that's true.
But you gave a caveat that you removed the centers of excellence.
That's true.
Which actually have bigger numbers and are better resourced, probably with minimal transfers, and they were very, very more likely to continue with this kind of thing compared to the ones that
But then the conclusion is that. What is the conclusion compared to this result?
Okay, it was sustained within 1 year after its
conclusion. Oh, recommendation.
Recommendation.
Implementation science project should design a sustainability period in the implementation plan to assess uptake and reinforcement of activities.
What is that supposed to be?
Pardon? Because when you look at my core, one is that during the there were facilitators and barriers found that actually some of the, not all, were really sustained, because that's why I said they provided a graph, the table which would have shown that some of the health centers were not sustained, despite that the overall average showing that there was sustainability, but when you look at individual clinics, it was not really all of it sustained. So
actually the question is, those clinics which did not sustain, there was no sustainability plan. Is that what you're saying? I mean, you're saying implementation science program should design
sustainability periods.
So are you saying that those clinics which did not sustain did not have a sustainability
program?
I mean, no, exactly. Is that what I mean?
No. Yes, I understand.
The Ministry of Health was involved, you said, in the START project.
Yes, and
they promised.
Yes.
But you are recommending that, but despite the promising, they did not fulfill.
No, here I'm saying that because we induced Ministry of Health, that's why the study was sustained.
And that's a sustainability program.
That's a sustainability program. So maybe I wanted to ask, what did we think when we are designing this study? Do you remember that?
Yes, we are thinking that what happens after the study has ended? Mm-hmm. Do the one that what they implicate the study, the intervention which we had put in place, does it continue or is it the same or is it reduced?
And we were worried.
Yes, that's true.
So I think these results suggest that more implementation studies should be promoted, because they contribute to, even when they end, as opposed to the randomized controlled trials and stuff that bring in a lot of expertise outside of the usual clinic staff and reagents and the things that people do. Remember that this study, the implementation studies, basically work more with the local staff within the facilities. Mm-hmm. And that is kind of an inbuilt sustainability plan as compared to the, say, the randomized controlled trials and stuff. So I think I would start from that perspective rather than shooting myself when...
Yeah, shooting yourself that...
Yeah, but anyway, we haven't looked at this, I hope.
So this should be something that may happen already in the beginning when it starts, and this also that was being designed. When you implemented the study, did you look at what might explain why things changed and worked well? In terms of the knowledge of the people, what explains that things worked?
Or
For the main study, because that explanation, what changed in me, who is at the clinic implementing those start activities, all changed in the environment in which I work, that explains that things continue worked well. By understanding that, it's like you did a pre-intervention assessment of knowledge, attitude, and self-efficacy. And then, at the end of it, you see what has changed because of your interventions. And that change may explain what may be made it work. And maybe that may be important in looking at what may sustain that intervention.
It's an excellent comment. So actually, in this study, which what Richard did show here, we had a qualitative component, and we published that work in December. Yeah. And I think I shared those papers. Yeah. What happened is one is that the program that that actually conducted the implementation study within the region had a strong relationship with the different players from the district to the facility heads to some of the patients. The peers were supported in a way by the program. And also in this program, what happened, something that we had not anticipated, the peer educators or the peer counselors actually played a very critical role in helping other patients to start. Because they would go and tell them, you know, when I came here, I was robbed by the police team in the clinic. But when I took my medicine, I'm doing well. Do you really want to wait until you are as sick as I was before you are starting this treatment? And so the patients could actually clearly identify with the peers in the way that we are. And these continue to be in the facility.
And those same things which were there would be looked at as a model of sustainability. What extent are these things continuing to be in place? Because they made it work. If we are to look at sustainability, it means these very things may be looked at and say, if they break, probably it will not break. And that way, strengthen your way of looking at sustainability.
Yes, thank you very much for that question. And indeed, that's why I was, when Jen presented, I said that he asked them what are you going to do specifically to say that this, what you are going, the intervention you are going to put in changed. Mm-hmm.
That question has been asked quite, because they are saying what exactly intervention, but one of the weaknesses we did not really put into quantification measurements. Like for example, the counseling we did, the education there, we trained the people. It wasn't really like, they would be asked, but we want to say that we did one was central education, then two was clinic-based education, three was mentorship at the site, that how people would be working. So that's how we went on about the study. And for some time, we had not really what, like put them into good context.
And those, when you educate someone, as much as you want that person, may have knowledge.
Yes.
But that knowledge may be in doing something. Yes. So you may measure that in the actual activity. So that's where you may look at these people, peer counselors, you educated them. What they were doing versus what they did later, but what sustained that, the mentorship. So I think you need to look at those deeper to understand sustainability.
All right. I think you've got some feedback. We will listen to the last